coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are now transmitting worldwide in overdrive. We're going to get to many of these veteran calls as we can, Navy vets and others. And I've kind of gone slow here. I apologize. Let's go quick. Michael in FEMA Region 9, guess that's on the West Coast somewhere, formerly part of the U.S. What is your experience with the VA?
Alex, I'm employed by the VA. I clean toilets and showers and tubs for veterans. And my personal experience is, you know, I've had a lot of long wait times and this and that, but I got my eyes open and I'm awake. And if I see anything wrong going on, I'm going to bring it to attention. What my concern is my son, who you kind of hit on this a couple of callers ago. He's got a full ride scholarship at a university back in North Carolina. He was ROTC head of, commander of his high school as a junior and a senior. He's got a full ride, and he wants to get a four-year degree in criminal justice. And I asked him, I said, you going to be a cop? And he kind of chuckled and said, I don't know, maybe, Pops. And I said, well, if you're going to be a cop, be a good cop. But then he wants to go to 82nd Airborne. I'm trying to expose to him.
Well, I think it'd be great to join the military, even though they go on some evil missions, because we need good people in the military if they weren't giving them experimental vaccines. I think no one should join the military. We should make it a big political issue that they're still doing experimentation on them. And people say, well, they don't have rights. They're troops. No. Federal law says you can't give troops experimental vaccines. It's illegal. And that's how we got the anthrax shot stopped twice and a bunch of others. So, and InfoWars was at the forefront of that. And I'm proud of that. Because let me tell you, they can make the troops take shots. They can make us take shots. So we're all in this together. God bless you, Michael. I don't know. It'd be better for him to be a cop than in the 82nd Airborne. I mean, they'll automatic re-up him. They will use him like birdcage liner. So I would never do that. I understand he wants to be a warrior. He's a man. He wants to be challenged. He wants to show his mettle. But it's just they treat you like pure crap. Let's talk to Eric in Texas. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, Jay.
Hey, buddy. Army vet. Go ahead. Tell us your take on it.
I'm going to blow my whistle loud, partner. Look here. I had the anthrax shot before I went to Desert Storm back in 1990. Now, after the war, we got taken out to the destroyed tanks. I saw the T-72s laying in the battlefield. Now, I'm here to ask, why were we taken to a site that was very possibly destroyed by our depleted uranium shells at the M1A1, which I worked on, shoot down range?
No, that's right. You weren't supposed to be around those. Dr. Doug Rocky was there. Most of his team died.
I never have got an answer. I do have a letter from DOD, though, from 2000 that says if I was with my unit on the day specified, I probably was exposed to chemical fallout, possibly due to munitions being burned in Iraq. Another key point here, I used to go to the Austin VA, but now I go to Temple VA, and they don't diagnose PTSD. It's a big no-no. The director of the somewhere up in the chain put out the memo and said, you don't diagnose that. You diagnose anxiety, depression, irritability, and all these symptoms, but PTSD is off the books because it costs too much money. Austin American Statesman did an article on that, which I believe I still have a copy of it.
Incredible, sir. Look, I'm sorry to all the other vets. We'll do this again tomorrow. Barbara, Kathy, and John, if you give folks your number, we'll call you tomorrow, I promise. Or If you get back in, you'll go to the head of the line. I'm out of time. Nightly news tonight, 7. The good news is major attention's on the VA now. We may be able to get some reforms if people stay angry. Stay with us.
The United States spend the largest percentage of GDP in the world on healthcare. Why do we have the highest cancer rates on the